Hello everyone, welcome to HR Administ. My name is Swati, welcoming you to a video which is all about performance management. So this isn't a standard HR talk because I am aiming for practical insights that can make a real impact. So stick around because this video is going to make another HR process a whole lot simpler and more effective for you. So let's quickly jump in. Let us first understand the meaning of performance management process. Performance management is a set of processes and systems aimed at developing employees so that they can perform their job to the best of their ability. The goal is to help employees build on skills that enable them to perform their job at their roles and reach their potential and boost their success while also accomplishing the strategic goals of the organization. Effective performance management establishes communication between employees, managers, and HRs. It combines verbal and written components which take place throughout the year, culminating in an annual performance appraisal. The process involves the following components, and apart from this, career decision, including bonuses, dismissal, promotions, are also a part of performance management process. Let us understand why is performance management important, and here are 5 steps that tells us the importance of performance management. Firstly, this process can help you to strengthen the skills of your workforce from future perspective because establishing a continuous line of communication with your employees and monitoring their skills, learnings and training developments helps to uncover the potential skills and performance gaps in the organization. Secondly, when carried out effectively, this performance management process can set expectations for your employees in a more transparent way because it provides them with learning and development opportunities, a clear path in the organization, and an understanding of their role's impact on meeting the organizational goals. Plus, continuous performance management helps employees feel valued and cared for, making them more open to receiving constructive feedback and working to improve. Third point says that when an employee is able to see their progress at work and clearly understand their career path and they know what they need to do to earn a promotion, it leads to more engaged employees who are likely to stay with your organization. In the next point, establishing a culture of communication, transparency, and trust begins with leadership and HR initiatives that trickles down to the rest of the organization, and this includes the nature of your processes and a transparent policy. When the managers are open and share constructive and honest feedback with their employees, this encourages them also to be open and honest while building a mutual trust. And all this ultimately helps in developing the healthy company culture. In the last importance, managing employee performance ultimately leads to significant improvements in organizational performance that includes revenue growth and customer satisfaction. So helping your employees to learn, develop, and perform their roles has a positive knock-on effect on the wider business. Moving on to the stages of performance management process, these are the 4 main stages and each step is equally important and together form the backbone of the company's performance management process. The performance management process begins with the planning stage wherein HR and management needs to define many things like the job itself, the long-term and short-term goals, and develop a clear metrics that helps in explaining how those objectives and goals will be assessed. Goals should be clear, done in a smart format, and clear performance standards should be set. Employees should have the opportunity to give input on this material because they are the one doing their job and will have a key insight into what skills, competencies, and goals will best assist to achieve organizational goals. Second is the monitoring stage wherein HR and management is required to review the performance of their employees on the basis of the goals that were set in the first stage and provide feedback to their progress. doing this regularly rather than annually allows the issues to be highlighted and corrected sooner rather than later. These meetings should focus on solutions and coaching opportunities. If accountability is made into a negative, then employees will avoid it rather than being honest about where they were struggling. Management should be able to give and receive honest feedback and work with employees rather than adopting a combative stance. As the performance management process continues, management should revisit objectives to see if adjustments should be made, as well as pay attention to career development opportunities for their employees. Third stage is the reviewing stage, because at the end of the yearly performance management cycle, there should be an employee review, which is also known as performance appraisal. There should be a clear record from previous check-ins to show the employee's progress throughout the year. This performance review is the only step that looks backward to assess the behavior of the past year. There are some specific and must required questions to be asked during this conversation, and if you want, you can check the link in description box for the list of some basic questions asked in this kind of meetings. A key part of the review is to give and receive feedback. Management should give actionable feedback for the employees so that they know areas where they can improve future performance. The employee should also be invited to give feedback on the process and how management can do better on their end. The last stage of performance management process is the rewards and recognition, which is absolutely the key to this process, because employees will feel motivated only if they are given a reason to feel so. And although this reward is linked to monetary compensation from employees' perspective, but nowadays the employees' perspective has gone beyond the monetary compensation, like some new project, the company-wide recognitions, some time offs or leadership opportunities, and many more such things can also be given as a recognition to them. There you have the concise overview of performance management process. I hope I am able to equip you with the basic knowledge about the process. If there is any specific concern related to this, please mention in the comment section. I'll surely address all the concerns. And before you leave, don't forget to subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon to get connected with HR Administ.